Somebody used it. All right, let's check the oil. And yes, guys, checking the oil is part of our pre-trip because there's nothing more important than your engine oil. So I'm gonna get my light out. All right, oil's good. Now we can start her up. Actually, we need to unplug her. All right, hopefully she starts. You guys can see that I pushed in only my yellow, and just my red one is out, because apparently if you have both of them out, the engine would shut off a little bit. I don't know, it's something that has to do with California compliance or whatever, but as long as this is working, then pretty much that's all I need. Let's turn this on. Let me get myself logged in. Other miscellaneous stuff. Once I go park my car, then I'm gonna log myself on duty. Right now I'm just gonna keep it off duty until I get back. All right. I'm gonna go park my car and I'll meet you guys back here. All right, guys, just got done parking my car. Let's turn the dome light on. now I'm gonna be showing you guys what I do for my pre-trip. Let's attach my keys there. So I'm gonna put myself on duty. Oh, I need to certify some logs. Tuesday, yes. Thursday, yes. Probably do later. Alright, so I'm gonna put myself on duty. Pre-trip is what I'm gonna put. Truck's all fueled up and everything, so I don't think it needs to be refueled. Normally I do refueling at the end of each day. That way every morning I don't have to worry about it. Alright, I'm on duty. Now I'm gonna do my pre-trip. So really the first thing I do before I even start the Zonar pre-trip is just do like an overall view of the whole truck. Pretty much I'm looking for any noticeable issues, so any leaks on the ground. Normally this time I look at the lug nuts too. Make sure the tire's inflated. I'm gonna do it all the way around. No signs of leakage. Make sure tires are inflated. Make sure that the kingpin is attached, which it is. Lights are working, mud flaps are secured. That signal's working. Make sure all wheels are inflated. Again, look at the lug nuts. Make sure all of them are present. And I'll do more of a thorough inspection when we do the Zonar. And I'll show you guys what a Zonar is and what it does. That's what we use around here. Gotta whack these really hard. Lug nuts. No missing lug nuts. Lights are working. Got the mud flap fixed, because last time it was like, it was off. And look at the lug nuts. All of them are present. With our Zonar. So I'll go to EVIR. Start. Tractor trailer. Missing mud flap. Yep, I checked that already. It's all good. Mileage. 29547. Alright, starting from the in cab. There's no warning lights are on, everything's all good. Signals work. Let's see, I'm gonna test my horn actually. City horn works. Air horn works. Alright, now the compliance. For those of you guys who don't know, this is pretty much a binder full of truck compliance stuff. So your insurance, your registrations and everything. Alright, my permits are good. Alright, so all that is checked out alright. Now we're gonna go to the front of the truck. So my front lightings, both lights are good. I'm gonna try to climb up and see the clearance lights up top if I can. Let's see, that one's working. I'm gonna go over here. Yep, they're all working. All right, we checked the lug nuts, looked at the engine. Fuel level. We checked our oil. Again, no leaks. All right, we're seem to be fine right there. Make sure all my lines are in. Hydraulic lines and my air lines, my electric lines and my tarp line. Make sure it's secured. Lug nuts again. It's this one.
Stuff in between. Nuts.
Lights are working. Missing bolts or nuts. This truck is ready to roll out. All right, just got done talking with dispatch. Looks like we're gonna be, today's gonna be an easier day. We're gonna be hauling dirt from a pit in Ashland, and we're gonna be taking it to Thomas Estates, which is pretty close to where we're gonna be loaded. Alright guys, it's gonna be a long drive over there. We're gonna be pretty much hauling dirt all day long. Try and get as many rounds as we can. Clean this a little bit better. I assume it's gonna be at the same pit where it was a couple weeks ago. So hopefully it's the same area, same place, same pit. All right, guys, we're out. 97, go down I-80. GANA dump trucks here, so at least I'm not the only GANA guy here. Guys are getting loaded. I'm gonna put my tag axle down. All right, and that should go down in a couple of seconds. Down. just got done with my last load. Now I'm ready to head back to Roca. My hope is that the way station that we passed this morning is still closed. That's what my hope is. If it's still closed, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take I-80, take I-80 all the way to 77, and then take 77 all the way to Roca. Just like the way we came this morning. I'm just really hoping that the way station is closed. If not, then I might as well pull in. This is gonna be a hard or tight turn, I should say. Not only because of the gate, but we got like pallets and everything that we have to avoid. Pallets are over there. Moved. No vehicles coming, so we're good. Yeah, we got pallets in there. Oh shoot. Alright. Hopefully we can get this as smoothly as possible without hitting anything. Alright. Look at my mirrors, the pallets are down there. Now, some guys have just told me that if you have no choice, might as well just run over those pallets. But I just looked at it closely. There were nails sticking up. So it's always best to try to avoid everything if you can. Try not to run them over. Because like I said, those pallets had nails on them that are sticking up. If I were to run them over, I would most likely puncture my tires. How'd you get here? I guess I was wrong when I said take I-80 and Highway 77. What's that?
You got one of them papers?
Yeah, I gotcha.
I just got here like a minute before you did.
Well, it's not a huge difference then. Oh, hold on. This one has my name on it.
Hey, you say Jeremy works here?
I don't know where he's at.
But did you see that he works here?
Yeah. Yeah, I saw
him in the morning.
This morning?
Yeah. And he has a big old beard like that big.
Yeah, he sent me a pic on Messenger.
Huh?
He sent me a picture on Messenger.
Oh, yeah?
Is he still training? Or is
Yeah. Jeff? Yeah.
Okay. get some fuel. Well, right now I'm just gonna go park the truck, call it a night. Hope you guys enjoyed. Alright, hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know, I'm open for suggestions. And I'll see you guys on the next one.